Starting to the top right is the Terran player for LGIM. It is
LGIM happy.
Happy with good performance here in the past. Was not too successful in the last Code S season, unfortunately for him, dropped out in the first round. To the bottom left starts his opponent. He wants to go to Code S. It is a Protoss for Team MVP. It is
MVP Finale.
Finale, a man of many haircuts, looking a little bit more trimmed this time. And similar playstyle to his teammate Tails, I would say.
You know, the really interesting thing about Happy, in my opinion, is that the last Code S season proved to be somewhat a little bit weird. The problem that we had was just Symbol and Seed wanted to play against each other once again because Seed was still holding a Symbol was still holding a little bit of a grudge because he lost to Seed in the season before in the semifinals. So they ended up in the same group, and when it was time for Symbol to actually pick a player, he looked straight at the LGIM player, picked Happy because he wanted to be a little bit mean. It was just such a mean move, but from his perspective, of course, kind of a funny one. He wanted to have the two LGIM players in the same group fighting against each other. And yeah, that was very unfortunate for Happy, who was one of the guys who then in the end lost. He dropped down and had to play in Code A against Bogus.
One of the other interesting things about Happy is that his eyebrows actually look like Goomba's eyebrows.
Yeah.
I just wanted to mention that once more. But no, you're so right. Jokes aside, he had that unfortunate group situation. And I think that's one of the cool things about group nominations, because you can sometimes force these situations on people. You can make alliances, you can make agreements, you can do all sorts of things with those groups. I really like that. He's going for a quick tech lap here, and he's going to make a Marauder. He looks like he wants to Marauder expand. This is so strange.
Yeah, and talking about him and his style against Protoss in general, or his results, he looked really strong against Protoss in all these matches that I just mentioned. In his Code S group, he had to play against Rain. Rain then advanced to the semifinals in Code S. And he, Happy won. Happy won against Rain. He took down Genius before that. Won against Vampire also in the up and downs of last season and against Killer. So his Terran versus Protoss is really, really strong these days. And this is one of the things, of course, that Finale has to prepare for. Finale is in his weakest matchup here. Against Terran, he only has a 47 win ratio. And he lost to players like Hack, for example, in Code A. That's the reason why we have him today in the up and downs.
Yeah. This Zealot pressure is actually, if he continues it, he's going to get caught with a concussive shell, and that is it. But I love this choice to just run in on it. He's going to get a few hits.
Well, he knows exactly that the Zealot won't be able to escape from this point on.
He actually only got one hit, though. Really nice micro by Happy.
Yeah, well done.
But he saw what he needed to see. I believe he saw the Command Center, that is. No, actually, he did not. He did not see that Command Center. He didn't quite get into range of it, so that's a little bit scary for him, because now he's going to be thinking, what if he's going for a 3-racks attack?
And he's going for double gateways because we don't see the Robo straight away. And now Happy in a position where he decides, okay, I'm just going to produce more Marauders, I'm getting my Stim, and I'm trying to put some aggression on you. And if you don't pay attention, you will lose Stalkers and Zealots.
This looks like a very old Protoss versus Terran. You know, 1-racks expand into follow-up of barracks. You pressure the Protoss with your first few Marauders. The Protoss is getting those gateways done.
If he walks up this ramp, he can take those Stalkers down without a problem at all. There is no Sentry. There's nothing.
He needs to be very careful. The Warp Gate research is done. This is the critical moment for Finale. If that bunker finishes, this is so scary. This is exactly why Finale has this pylon on the wall. He wants to use that low ground warp in. Here he goes. Force of the cancel, and those units get out of there. He didn't quite know what was up at the top of that ramp. Yeah. He decided, you know what, I'm not sticking around. That bunker's not finishing. I'm not going to be here.
If Happy knew what Finale had, he would have just attacked. He would have not been able to finish the game, but he would have been able to do a lot of damage. He's playing it a little bit cautious here, but he definitely had a chance to do a lot more damage. And look at what we have on the production tab for Finale now. He's actually going up six gates.
He's going to go for a 6 gateway timing attack off the 2 Nek'Sai. This is going to be something. Oh, if he loses these units, not going to work. But he does save them.
Can he take it, though? We have now Stim will be done by the time he attacks. A lot of Marauders. Now we have the double reactor at the 2 additional barracks that he has. The forward pylon is being killed, at least the first one.
Yeah, he's lucky he got that second one up. The probe got away.
double bunker right now. I'm not quite sure if Finale can really break through here.
If he hits this next warp in and goes before the bunkers are done, I think he could. But he's walking all the way around because he wants to hide this attack.
And now four Marines at a time are being built. Stim is going to be done. It's not only about the Marauders. He has a lot of Marines then to back this up.
He can put units on the high ground on that cliff as well. And this is not the right build to choose against what Happy is doing, I feel. But Finale doesn't quite know 100% what Happy's plan is and how many Marauders he has.
Happy is heavily supply blocked, which is a huge problem for him now. He might even have to call down extra supplies if he wants to continue this, because he needs more units. He's starting his combat shield, but it will be quite a long time until he can finally start producing units again. Here come a few supply depots at the front, and now Happy might not have enough. Here comes Finale trying to go in. The force fields are decent, making sure that those SCVs can't repair the bunker. But we have Stim, and Stim has been used. A lot of units for Finale are blocked by the one supply depot that he's building and the additional bunker.
He needs to get that bunker down, and he's just not quite able to do it yet.
Five Marines at a time are now being produced. SCVs are being used as a defensive shield.
And it looks like he's still just not going to be able to hold here. There's too many Zealots at the back. The next bunker finishes, but there's only one unit inside. He gets the rest in, though.
This is so close,
actually. I think he's gonna break through, though. There's too many Protoss units now. Those units are low on hit points.
I think so, too. Finale is completely capitalizing on the fact that Happy could not produce any units at all. There would have been at least two additional rounds of Marines, but that's what he does not have, and he does not have the firepower now. Yep. Finale is going through with this, and he's basically putting it back into the Stone Age in regards to his economy. 19 Harvesters against 30. The expansion is under siege. He can warp on the high ground now.
Oh my god. Yeah, the Zealots are going to stop that bunker and also rip through these Marines. So many SCVs going down, and the depot falls. He can walk in the front door, and Happy is going to have to GG here. That supply block, I think, may have been what ended him. Otherwise, you know, he had so many Marauders out, he had so much production. I feel like he could have held also if his SCVs were able to repair a little bit faster. It was kind of a weird choice by Finale, knowing there were that many Marauders. He should have assumed Stim would have been out as well. But it worked out for him, yep. So props here, GG.
GG, game over, and Finale takes the game. Happy must be really disappointed here. He had all that he took, but then he was supplier blocked, and he was producing 5 Marines at a time at this point, so he would have had at least 5 Marines, probably even 10. That was really unfortunate for Happy. His stim was done, his defense was set, he had 2 bunkers, but he just did not have enough. This supplier block made sure that he didn't have the army. Even with those units, it would have been a tough battle. But as long as you defend against this push, the Protoss player does not have the tech to really follow it up. Happy already had his factory done, and that was... He can't be happy about that.
No, absolutely
not.
No
puns intended here.
I actually didn't catch that one. You got me there, man. Anyways, that game was definitely weird. From the beginning, it was weird because we saw a Marauder expand. You don't see that all too often. Then he wasn't quite able to capitalize on it. The production of I almost said Tales, of Finale, of course, was just too much for him there, and the supply block really, really hurt his chances. But now we're going to have our last two players who are going to put their names on the scoreboard. They are going to be Minchul and, of course, Sparta coming in now.
MC against Sparta, that's right. So we have Schritt Commando player, SK. Schritt Commando was the name of the team back in the
cool
Warcraft
name,
3
man.
Days, but they changed it. Now it's only SK Gaming.
Well, they were like, too many people can't say this, so...
Nobody calls them Schritt Commando anymore. But that was the original name of the team. And of course, Sparta here starting for StarTail.
Yeah, he looks actually really good in his StarTail uniform. It's one of the first times he's actually been able to wear it. I mean, this season of Code A, he's just coming off of ZenX. A lot of people don't know that, but he was once a ZenX player, one of their better Terrans, in fact, back a long time ago.
It was just so awesome for StarTail when they merged with ZenX. They got so many good players, of course, live. He won the GSL Code S season, the last one, finally defeated the StarTail curse where they always came in second for some reason. But now they have this awesome team with a lot of depth to it as well. All those Zerg players that switched over helped them a lot. Now we're heading into the game. MC at a disadvantage a little bit because it's Abyssal City. That's of course a problem. We saw the map yesterday. And Protoss players are just struggling here. Sparta on the other hand, now can he do it? He is the underdog.
I actually really like both players' hoodies. The SK one looks really nice on MC, but the Star Tail jersey has always been a favorite. By the way, the map is loading. Abyssal City, MC against Sparta. The GSL up and down matches for Season 5 of CODES, cast by Cutter and Wolf.